The fifth day of competition at the 27th Universiade in Slovakia. After 2 days of glorious sunshine, these spectacular Tatra Mountains are again shrouded by low cloud. But that hasn't stopped the supporters from pitching camp, and nor has it disturbed the athletes. No biathlon today, so the action all focused on Strbske Pleso. Adam Cieslar looking for a second gold in the Nordic combined mass start, and the Russians odds-on favourite for the women's team ski jump. And welcome to Strbske Pleso. We are here for the Nordic Combined today. The cross-country skiers are having a morning off. They've been practicing for the relays. But that means still plenty of action. A little bit of snow falling this morning. We haven't got the glorious sunshine we had the last couple of days. Plenty of interest. Early morning start, 9 o'clock in the morning here in Slovakia for the start of this Nordic Combined. It's the individual mass start, 10 kilometres. So 10 kilometres of cross country, and then of course they'll be flying down the jump. The Russians have been dominating the medals table. There's a chance for some of the other nations to get themselves on the board. Great interest obviously in the Poles. Adam Cieslar picked up gold in a fabulous Gunderson a couple of days ago. He edged out David Weld. Both of those will be in contention today. There is Velt leading at the moment from Watanabe, the Japanese Takahiro, 22. And there you see Wantelok as well, one of the Poles. They've got a pretty strong side, the Poles, and obviously they've come good in ski jumping over late with Kamil Stock, the Olympic champion, Adam Marish, of course. So their ski jumping is pretty strong. That means that a decent showing on the cross country will give them a good chance of picking up some medals later on in the table. This is Samir Mastiev battling it out with Takahiro Watanabe for third and fourth. Mastiev, the Russian, flying the flag for Ural Federal University. He was eighth in the Gunderson, but doing well here. He's got World Cup experience and able to pick up third place. Here's Adam Cieslar. He's done well. They were all tucked into quite closely together. It's strung out a little bit in the last stretch. And it's Adam Cieslar who's going to come through and take second place. And that will give him a great opportunity of making it double gold for him. This is David Velt, the German, who took the silver medal in the individual Gunderson, 20 years old, from Mittwoch. He's done well at youth level and hoping to add another medal. So Velt winning, that means he takes 120 points from that. Cieslar is 9.8 points behind. Mastiev in third is 15.3 points behind the leader. Watanabe, 16 points behind. It's a big jump from Matthias Vantelok that is going to throw the cat among the pigeons. And there he goes, and that was a massive jump, 94 metres. Came 16th in the cross country, gave up 2 minutes 17, started 34.3 points behind the leader, David Velt. Terrific performance. This is Velt, he was concerned. Ski jumping, not his strong point, and it was to let him down slightly. 87 metres for the German, which certainly got him up onto the podium. The Poles, though, happy with that. And the last to go, Adam Cieslar. He took the lead after the first jump. This is the second, 88.5 metres. And that gave him a total of 216.9. The gold medal going to Poland, Adam Cieslar. Beautiful technique. And you can see the celebrations in the Polish camp. Another gold medal for them in the Nordic combined competition. Adam Cieslar winning 216.9, David Veld 210.3, and in third place, Matthias Wantelok, who really came through extremely well on the ski jump. So, celebrations for Poland, gold medal for Adam Cieslar.
Welcome to Strbske Pleso, where a little bit of history will be made at the 2015 Universiade. Women's ski jumping, a relatively new discipline, and for the first time today, there will be a women's team competition for the women. Stay with us to see if Russia can continue their domination of the Universiade. It's about 2 degrees minus zero, and they're the Russian fans and team, hoping that their team will get another gold. They're the big, big favourites. There are 5 teams here. One is a mixed team made up of Svetlana Gladykova and Katarina Karl. There's the Chinese of Tong Ma and Xiaoyu Li. Czech Republic, Vladina Puskova and Mikhaila Dolazalova. Japan, Aki Matsuhashi and Yuka Kobayashi. And the big, big favourites are Russia, Anastasiya Gladysheva and Irina Avvakumova. So in the first round is Aki Matsuhashi. She was a 6th place in the individual competition, 172.4 points. Expected to be silver medalists here. Didn't surprise a few people as Matsuhashi. And that's a better than expected jump. Good work. It's well over 80 meters, close to 85, 84, yeah. And that surely will at least tie up a silver. Might put a bit of pressure on the Russians as well. Jump from the Japanese there, and the star mark's not bad either. 96.2 the total is the big star of this competition, Irina Avvakumova, former Russian national champion. 6th in the overall World Cup standings, and she needs a big jump, but she's got one just short of 90, and that'll put Russia back ahead. And they need Avvakumova to be in form in Slovakia. The winner of the individual competition a couple of days ago, quite easily as well. And that's why Russia are the big, big favourites here. It's going to be 94.7 points. 107 in total. And that puts Russia ahead at the halfway mark. There you have it, 13 points. That's a decent cushion. Most people would have expected to be a bit more. Czech Republic should be okay for a bronze. So get ready for the second round of competition now. each of the jumpers will go again. Here's Anastasiya Gladysheva from Nizhny Novgorod. 24.5 in the first jump for her. Gladysheva, the bronze medalist in the individual competition a few days ago. There's Gladysheva. She's well short of 90. And she's disappointed with that, 84.5. Maybe the Japanese will be in with a shout. Only 75 meters. And that's disappointment for Russia. And a surprise could be on the cards, 174.8. The total. Dolozalova and the Czech Republic should be okay for a bronze. Silver medalist in the individual 2 years ago. If she doesn't make any mistakes, should be going home with the bronze, and that should be enough. Dolozalova and the Vladina Pushkova, Czech Republic. At least a bronze, and they'll be happy with that against two very strong teams, Japan and Russia. Avvakumova, the pressure is on, because Russia are not leading ahead of the final jump, which is sensational, really. But that's a sensational jump. Avvakumova, that's 90 metres. And that'll put real pressure on Kobayashi, who's still to go. Brilliantly done, good star marks as well. The V shape there. Good aerodynamics. And just when Russia needed Avvakumova, she's come up with a brilliant leap. 18 from each of the judges. So it's still in the Japanese hands. They can still win it. But Kobayashi needs a big leap of about 86 meters. It would be a sensation if Russia are denied. The huge favorites, but Japan can still do it. Can Kobayashi get there? She looks a little bit short. We'll wait for the judges' marks, but I think she's about a meter short. Heartbreak for them. Indeed, it's not quite enough, 192.2. It's been a fine performance, you know, from Japan, but it's Russia's gold, and Irina Avvakumova taking the plaudits. They have the gold, Kobayashi and the Matsuhashi, a creditable silver, Czech Republic third.
Education meets sport and culture. On your mark. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.